Today, we're gonna do a video on how y'all can go do one and how I did it. So we're gonna hop straight into it. Like I keep saying, make sure you liking, make sure you commenting, and subscribe. Smash that subscribe button, smash that like button. We on the road to 500 subs, man. Let's get lit. Y'all gotta start back to when y'all in 7th, 8th grade. I gotta have that mindset, that dog mentality that you better than everybody else. 8th grade football ain't nothing. I mean, everybody can be an all-star in 8th grade. I mean, I was an all-star in 8th grade. I was an all-star all through grammar school. I mean, that's nothing. Recruits not looking at that. But just make sure you're building your confidence. You're getting a little pride and moxie, but don't get too confident. Don't get too cocky. Don't get cocky at all, actually, I should say. But you should just have that mindset going into high school that I'm that nigga.
Wait a minute.
I want to say 8th grade and freshman year, even though it's 1 year, it's a big jump. It's a big jump in maturity, man. Those guys you're going against freshman year are going to be way bigger, way stronger, way faster, way more mature than those guys who are facing in grammar school football, little league football, man. So, you got to get your mindset right. You got to get your body right. You got to make sure you're eating healthy. Make sure your endurance, your stamina is all up. But one of the key things you can do early on as a youngin', to be honest, is make sure you're eating right. Make sure you're consuming the right things. I'm not just talking food. Make sure you're consuming the right things. Make sure your head at the right place, man. That was a big problem for me, because my body wasn't ready for the transition. I was still, even though I was one of the most athletic, one of the fastest, one of the maybe biggest on my 8th grade team. You know what I mean? I wasn't ready for the conditioning we was doing as a freshman. Freshman condition, anybody know this, freshman condition is the hardest condition, because they gonna accept you into the school and then try to break you and try to tell you how it's gonna be on varsity, even though it's not gonna be like that. Freshman condition is the hardest condition. Make sure you got your pickle juice. Make sure you got your water jug. Another essential thing, when you going into your freshman year of high school, no matter if you O-line, D-line, secondary, skill position, offense or defense, it don't matter. Make sure you fine and tune your craft, man. Cause like I said, it's a big jump from 8th grade to freshman. Make sure you fine and tune your craft. Make sure you going somewhere that got O-line, D-line training, receiver training, DB training. For me, it was 707, Boone Football, the best 707 team in the nation. I mean, I'ma show you a clip where I went from. I went from lining up like a dork to saucing people off the line, saucing people off routes. I mean, it was a big jump from what I had learned from grammar school. Cause grammar school, y'all, like, okay, they play receiver, but do you really play receiver? What are you running? Wheel routes, screen routes? Like, you don't really play receiver in grammar school. Like, you need to learn the fundamentals and the basics of actually being a receiver or whatever it is at your position group. So you wanna take that extra time to go to this performance center, that performance center, in order to make you a better player at that position. Because I'm telling you, once you get to high school, it's going to be a big jump. Before you even start your freshman year of high school, you should be thinking about networking and recruiting, even though it can't come to maybe sophomore year for some people, or even junior year for some people, depending on when you get pulled up to varsity. But you want to make sure your Twitter is active, and that you got some type of recruiting profile to show scouts, man. That is essential. You need networking. You need a profile and able to show scouts who you are, what you do, where you're from. Because they want to see that early on and later when they start recruiting. So get that out of the way first, so you don't have to worry about it down the line, because Twitter is essential. You need Twitter. You need to set your Twitter up. You need to network yourself. Build your brand and build yourself. I probably had over, you want to text over maybe 50 or 60 coaches. Text Text them your film. Text them your highlights. Show them how big you are. Show them how fast you are. Show them how strong you are. Show them how you do this well. Show them how you do this better than other people. It's only going to help you in the long run. Like I said, it's my Twitter. These are my messages over the years. All of these went to coaches. All of them. You're going to see some check marks because those are coaches that have that are verified on Twitter. Big Ten coaches, SEC coaches, ACC coaches, MAC coaches, Sun Belt coaches, all different types of conferences, man. I'm telling you, freshman year, your mindset shouldn't necessarily be, oh, let me be the best freshman. Let me do this well. Let me be adequate for the freshman level. Let me be established for the freshman level. No. Show them that you need to be playing on the next level. Do things and show things that exhibit that you should be playing on the next level so you can get that varsity spot as a sophomore, not as a junior. Because that extra year of film is only going to help you. So, I mean, you can have certain people that brag about their freshman highlights, this and that. Oh, I did this freshman year. I did that freshman year. I mean, I had maybe close to 1,000 all-purpose yards freshman year. It don't mean shit at all. Didn't mean shit. Throw it out the window. Throw freshman year out the window because it don't mean shit. You want to use your freshman year to set you up to get that varsity spot for that offseason, your freshman offseason, could be the offseason that, like me, your coach pull you into his office or pull you somewhere to talk to you and tell you, we're thinking about moving you up next year. We want you on our team. We want you to be a leader for our team once you're a junior. We want you to get that extra year of film and that extra year under your belt so you can be comfortable under the offense, under the defense, just under their scheme and game plan. So that's why I'm telling you, freshman year is a vital year to work on your skill position or your O-line or D-line skill, man. I'm telling you, Boone football has helped me tremendously. I showed you how I lined up as an eighth grader. I only played running back in grammar school, but never take for granted who you can learn from. Some of my guys that I'm still really close with today. I mean, I probably haven't told them this, but I never really trained for it. I just watched. Just watch and learn. Like, it literally, that's all you gotta do. I'm gonna show you a jump from 8th grade to freshman summer. But, like I said, I was watching guys like Jaden Thompson, dudes like Antonio King, and dudes like Marquise Buford. Those are three of my homies that I just learned from by just watching. Just watching the way they line up, watching their footwork, watching how they come in and out of their routes, watching things like that. Little things go a long way. And although I was an athlete, I didn't have the skill. I couldn't run a route. I couldn't break out of a route. I could go up and catch a ball maybe, but I couldn't give you a stick off the line. I couldn't stop on a dime. Like, those guys really showed me like what it meant to do that and how to do that. So just by watching and being attentive, just showed me, playing behind those guys, just showed me how to be a better After you got that skill training down packed, after you got your three-step, if you're a lineman, once you got your releases, your sticks as a receiver, just your DB footwork, your hip flexibility, your hip work as a DB, you ready. You ready for what I would impress sophomore year? You want to take care of your body, man. You really want to take care of your body. You want to be drinking a gallon of water a day. Make sure you're taking your vitamins. Make sure you're getting your greens in. This is something that I didn't do that I wish I would have. So I'm telling y'all, I'm giving y'all the keys that I didn't even do. That I look back and I'm like, damn, like, would have made me a more successful player if I would have did it. But make sure you're doing all the little things right that go into body preparation and sophomore season, dude. Sophomore season is a fun time, man. I'm talking fun. fun times. When you a sophomore, maybe you in the bag, maybe you looking up to the juniors and seniors that are on the varsity team. You probably not get that much play, but you just moved up because you got potential. That might have been, might have not been me in my case, but after two or three games, they knew what the real deal was. I mean, sophomore year is when you really want to make a name for yourself. You want to go the hardest in calisthenics. Well, not calisthenics. You want to go the hardest in the running, go the hardest in the conditioning. Make sure you're the first in the locker room, the last to leave. Make sure you're doing everything right and abided by your coaches. Make sure you're coachable, man. Be coachable. Coaches don't like when you're disobedient and you're going to do whatever you want to do and you're going to get out there and not follow what they want to tell you to do. They don't like that. So just train your mind to be disciplined, man. Discipline. You got to be disciplined in life. You got to have balance. This is when it starts to get more and more and more vital that you have a Twitter or a networking service or you're paying somebody to do your recruiting or whatever. Have a set up a recruiting profile. But the easiest thing is just get a Twitter. Just get a Twitter. I'm telling you, my sophomore year is probably when I didn't start my first game as a sophomore. I scored. But it took them two games after that to start me. I got I had a really big kick return in a game that we were down at half, and I brought us back into the game. Basically, nobody knew who I was. We needed a spark plug. We needed something that was gonna get us going. We were down two tutties at half. I open up the half. I take it to the crib. After that, that was the third game of the season. After that, I started ever since. Because I showed them I had that dog mentality. I showed them that I was better than the people in my spot. Period. So once you start to get this reputation and this film from week 3 to week 5 or week 3 to week 6, once you update your huddle, that's another thing I forgot to say. You gotta have a huddle. You need a huddle. Gotta have one. And the main thing with huddle, probably heard this 1,000 times. Coach is not gonna watch 2 to 3 minutes of your huddle, man. They gonna watch the first 35, 40 seconds. Put your best highlights in the front. Put your best highlights in the front of your huddle. Cause coaches, these college coaches ain't got time. They ain't got the time of day to sit through your huddle and, oh, let me watch this 6-minute video. No, they gonna turn that shit off if it's trash. They gonna turn it off. Like I was saying, my sophomore year, around my third or fourth game is when I really started getting like letters and stuff from my coach. My coach was dropping me off letters from colleges who visited or sent out mail. First one was like Cincinnati. Then I was getting stuff from like Ball State, Michigan State, Notre Dame. Like I started getting those letters like early. I mean, they're not necessarily offers, but they're letters that show interest. They're letters that show that they have an interest in you. They're watching you. They're going to recruit you in the future. So you always want to make sure you got a recruiting platform, a Twitter, a huddle, something that they can look into and text you and contact you if they want to. And that, I'm telling you, it's your junior year. It's where you really start to stand out. I'm telling you. It's when basically all your counterparts and all your friends who are on the same team as you as a freshman or the same grade as you are starting to come up to varsity because they didn't get moved up when you got moved up. So that's when you really starting to feel comfortable in the system and you got a leg up over everybody else. But it's one of the most essential years of your college career because your junior year is probably the most important year. Your junior year is where you want to go from here to here. It's when you want to take off and really become the player that you're going to be. So when I say that, you really want to be in the weight room, strong, hard, every day, every other day. I only miss Wednesdays. We went Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday. That's what we did at my school. I only miss Wednesdays. But I tell you, I went hard. You got to go hard in the weight room. You want to get that leg up. You already spent 1 year in the system, so you want to be as comfortable and as strong as you can and as dominant as you can the next season. Because sophomore year, I was like, okay, I mean, my strength was a problem, but I mean, I wasn't getting bullied, but like, you can tell, like, getting off the line and stuff, like, I never had a problem because I was too quick, but like, you always want to be stronger than your opponent. Junior year is also when the temptation comes, man. I mean, if you big man on campus, there's going to be a lot of distractions, man. The girls going to get the flocking. Half of them groupies don't even do it. Half of them groupies, they own everybody else's job too, I'm telling you. Half of them groupies. You're going to be going to parties. You're going to be influenced to drinking, smoking, vaping, like all that dumb shit that you really don't need to get into because you need to stay focused. You gotta know that goal in mind. You gotta have that goal and that mindset that what you wanna do at the end of the day. Like, ask yourself when you're around that type of crowd. Like, is this really for me? Like, do I really wanna do this? Is this what I need to do to go to the next level to better myself? Like, think about that. I mean, it's okay to have fun, hang out with your friends, but like, ask yourself, like, is this really me? Am I doing this for me? Or am I doing this just to fit in? So my first game sophomore year, I had three catches, something like that. I had a catch and I had a pick. I had a couple catches and a pick six, but all in the first half. In the second half, I'm on a bubble screen. It's a bubble screen. My school calls it something different, but it's basically a bubble screen. And a quarterback throws it out to me. I catch it. I start running. A dude, one of them ankle tacklers, helmet straight to my ankle. Hard sprain. That's 4 to 6 weeks, man. In the most vital season of my career, my junior season. After that, I start walking off the field. I'm like, damn, man, I can't do it. Like, my adrenaline was running too, but I'm still like, yeah, it gotta be serious. It gotta be a high sprain. Like, I really couldn't do it. And at this time, I was playing both ways. Like I said, I had a pick six prior in the first half, but I was playing both ways. So my trainer spatted me up, spatted my left ankle up. I'm like, man, I don't know if I can do this. You know, you just gotta be that competitor, man. My blood was rushing, my adrenaline was pumping, so, you know, I played the second half. I'm on defense, backpedaling, limping, doing all this, standing up and stuff, because I can't do anything. I mean, I'm trying to fight it out for my team. I'm trying to be tough. I'm trying to be a warrior, but it's limited what I can do. So my coach takes me off O. I just play D the rest of it. This is the main reason why I stress to you. Even though this could happen to anybody, you want to make sure your bones strong. Make sure you get your calcium. Make sure you get your greens, man. Because it's going to be vital. I'm telling you. Even though a freak accident can happen to anybody, it's vital. You got to do this. After that game, my coaches shouldn't have told me to play. It's always limping. But of course, they're going to try to make it like you're being soft, you're being this, you're being that. But a good coach would have told you to sit out. But hey. Yeah, so I played the next game against this team called Richards. Probably one of the toughest teams in our division at the time. And I messed up, man. I took maybe 10 painkillers that day, through school, after school, before the game. I took maybe 10 just to get the pressure off my ankle, because my ankle had a heartbeat, man. Like, it was a high sprain. Like, the practices before, I barely practiced the week prior. I practiced maybe the walkthrough and maybe one practice. And when I did practice, I didn't run at all. I just sat there and watched them do the plays. Like, I shouldn't have been playing at all. So that game, I barely get in on O, because I'm not a factor on offense. I can't cut, I can't run fast. I mean, I'm not effective, period. I mean, I ain't take it to heart, because, I mean, I saw myself. I mean, it hurt when I got in and out of my breaks. It hurt when I got off the line. Like, it hurt. I wasn't mad at my coach. I was like, okay. I'm not on O, okay, that's fine. They really needed me on D. This the type of shit that you really need me on D that game.
Yeah, I'll be reminiscing too much.
I got torched on D that game. And it's not even bad, it's a torching that I've received this year. I got torched, man. I was so mad at myself, bro. I couldn't help myself. I was injured. I shouldn't have been playing. So weeks and weeks go by. Nah, let's rewind. Not weeks, maybe a week. And the same schedule. I go to practice. I don't practice. I sit behind the huddle and I just watch everybody do the plays. I attempt to run and stuff here and there. And I just practice on the days that we had the walkthroughs, the Thursday walkthroughs before the game. I practice on those days. Same results. Play Loyola. I'm just fast forward this to you because it's embarrassing. We lost both of these games. We play Loyola and we play Montini. My ankle isn't stable, man. I shouldn't be in the game. Like, it hurt. I couldn't jump since the first half of the first game. Like, I wasn't able to fully jump since that game. And I'm playing. I'm guarding somebody. Like, you gotta do what you gotta do, but like, be smart. My athletic director kept telling me, Aaron, man, you going both ways. I can tell you hurt, man. Like, don't hurt yourself for them. Like, don't do that. Don't do this. It's not worth it. Like, you got a whole season ahead of you. Don't do this. Sit out. I'm like, nah, I can't. Coach Rowe, I can't do it. Gotta play for my team. I gotta do this. I gotta do that. So I keep playing. And, I mean, you lose both of those games against Montini. And you lose Richards, Montini, and Loyola. And it comes to like fourth or fifth game. I remember that week, we was playing somebody weak, so I'm like, I'm gonna sit out. Ain't no need for me to play, I'm gonna just sit out. So I sit out that one game. And it's homecoming. Next week is homecoming against Marion Catholic. I'm like, and one of my best friends played for him, Bryce Jackson. I'm like, I gotta play. This is the first time I was actually feeling. I felt maybe 80% that game. I was feeling the best that I felt. Maybe since week one when I hurt myself. I was feeling good. My adrenaline was pumping. It was cold as hell out there. I ain't had no sleeves on. I had KT tape on my arms. I ain't had no sleeves. I was ready. I was trying to look like a savage. I was ready. But that day, my season got cut short. One of my friends was actually the kicker, Ray Cantello. We kept joking with each other prior to the game. Because he kicks. Kept joking. Bro, you're not going to kick it to me. You're not going to do this. You're not going to do that. I had two kick returns the season before. So I was known for taking back kicks for Chris. He was like, you not gonna kick. I was like, you not gonna kick it to me. He was like, alright, I'll kick it to you. I'm not gonna kick it to you. Cause we will always hang out. So opening kickoff. I'm like, yeah, Ray ain't gonna kick it to me. I'm lined up on the right, KB on the left. I'm like, he not gonna kick it to me. This man kicks it to me. It bounces. I tell my friend Isaiah, I say, I got it. I take it in. I start running to the left. I see my friend Josh Coates over pursue, and I just cut in like this, and I start running up the field. Mind you, I was still kind of limping, even though it was the best I felt since week one. I was still kind of limping. My leg was not 100%. My cuts weren't 100%. So when I cut in, I only see the kicker. I'm like, I'm about to take this to the crib. Open a kickoff on homecoming. I'm about to take it to the house. So I'm running. I try to outside fake the kicker. But I guess he see his teammate behind me. So as soon as I fake out and come in, he gave me the most vicious trip ever. I don't know how the refs didn't call it. He gave me the most vicious trip. So he tripped me low, so his homie, because he saw his homie coming in, how to hit me. So they basically kind of like, he hit me low and his homie tackled me high. And on that play ended my junior season. I broke my tibia and my fibula that play. disgusting. My leg was like this. My leg was like a 60 degree angle. Like, it looked disgusting. I start crawling after I get hit. I'm thinking it's just my ankle, cause it felt like he knocked my ankle off. I turn around, my friend tried to help me up. I'm like, nah, bro, this shit not regular. Like, I was like, my ankle can't be sprained even more. I'm like, but maybe it is. So I turn over. I'm not gonna go into much more detail as to what happened to me. If y'all wanna hear about it, comment down below and let me know if y'all wanna hear more. But this is for y'all. So I'm gonna tell y'all how y'all can maximize y'all chances of going D1. So your junior year, you really need to be working. You really need that. That's your production year, baby. That's that cheddar year. That's when you really getting your cheddar. But my injury just goes to show you, never question God. He doing everything he's doing for a reason. Maybe I needed to slow down. Maybe I was moving too fast. Maybe my head wasn't where it needed to be. Maybe I was getting a big head, which I wasn't. Maybe God saw it in that light. But he always do stuff for a reason, I'm telling you. So count your blessings, man. Count your blessings each and every night, I'm telling you. Because anything can be taken from you just like that. I'm telling you from personal experience. We didn't have a season this year, man. So that season, that's my whole recruit. It is what it is, but maximize your opportunities whenever you get them. Make sure you're doing everything 110% because you never know when it can be taken from you. My injury just made me love football so much more. It made me not take for granted anything. I mean, if I even felt like it was a suicide or a ladder or a 100-yard sprint, like, after I got injured, like, it made me want to do that to my fullest potential. Before I injure up, I don't care if I come second, third, fourth, fifth, but it just make you love it so much more. I don't want y'all to get to that point where y'all gotta go through something like that to realize that you love the game that much and just don't take it for granted. Also forgot to mention, after my sophomore year of production, got my first offer, my first ACC offer from Boston College, my sophomore year. Now we're gonna fast forward to after I got injured. After I got injured, I got maybe 8 or 9 offers, but 8 or 9 more offers, but they weren't the caliber of the first offer I got. They weren't a clear reflection of what kind of player I was. I mean, even though I had bigger sights and bigger goals, I mean, God puts you in situations for a reason. If you weren't meant to be, you weren't meant to be. That's what I want to tell you. Don't get caught up in this Power 5, all these different conferences, and thinking that it reflects you as a player, because it really don't, man. You can go to the league out of whatever conference you go to, whatever school, D1, D2, D3. I'm telling you, they're going to find you. If you a dog, they're going to find you, period, at the end of the day. Just maximize your abilities and opportunities to be the best you can be. That's all you can do. And pray. Count your blessings. Pray to God, man. Last thing I want to say before I close out this video, man. Like I keep saying, bruh. Don't take anything for granted. Don't give anybody the upper hand, man. Take everything personal. Take everything personal. I'm telling you. Dudes who claim they was my brothers. Dudes who claim they my brothers. When I was laying on that hospital bed, fucked up, they was nowhere to be found, man. Take everything personal. Man, don't be mad. Oh, I'm taking his spot. Do what's best for you, because at the end of the day, it's only you and God. I'm the only two people you answer to at the end of the day. Take everything personal and maximize every opportunity that you get. Don't care who you hurting or who you stepping on in the process, because it really don't matter at the end of the day. It's you and God. For real, for a last thing, but I live in Illinois, 2020, 2021 have been a rough year for Illinois. I didn't even get to showcase my talent after my injury, so I just go to show you, man, God do everything for a reason. Don't pity yourself for one second. Don't say, oh, don't feel bad for yourself, man. Because just look at my story, and that just goes to show you there's multiple opportunities. I'm blessed to receive a full scholarship from Western Michigan University, and I want to maximize my opportunity there, and it was all because of God. I mean, I was a high caliber player back when I was a sophomore, but I mean, they haven't seen me since five games into my junior year. I only played five games junior year, but He's always going to give you opportunities to shine, man. And I always remember this. If it wasn't meant to be, don't force it. If it wasn't meant to be, don't force it. But yeah, I hope y'all took most of my tips and tools and applied them to y'all game, man. But whenever y'all need to work out or y'all got any type of questions or if I need advice, feel free to hit me up. Because I seen it, I've been through it, I've been playing national talent since I was in the 8th grade. Florida, Cali, Texas, I've been playing all them boys since I was in the 8th grade, man. Come on now. O-line, D-line, let me know. I got you. I mean, I can, even if I don't got you, I can refer you to somebody who is, who specializes in that position. So, but yeah, thanks for watching. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. If you're new, it's vital. Subscribe if you're new. But yeah, I'm gonna meet y'all at the top, man. I know. I believe in y'all. Y'all got it in y'all. I'm gonna meet y'all at the top. Just keep grinding. Keep working every day. And separate yourself. Defeat the odds. And remain humble. Peace.
Go. Hey. She asked for some skrilla, I told her bitch no. I'm next, catch bullets, ain't talking to you. This is the roof, finna pick up a load. No, almighty soul, bitch, I'm on my glow. We going down the middle, let him know on the dough. Just pulled up a four, put his brains on the floor. I ran out of drink, I need me some more. Our niggas too sneaky, gotta watch what I post. Go, go, you know we ain't going to block all day, ain't talking no post. You catching that traffic.